worship, and as we pray, chains are broken, and we are free. When we worship, Lord, when we worship, it's really simple. We say as we pray, chains are broken, Lord, and we are free. We are free when we worship, Lord.
that Jehoshaphat went to seek the Lord, and God told him that they wouldn't need to fight their battle in order to win the war. But what they would need to do is just praise him, just to worship him. And we see that Jehoshaphat, that the word of the Lord came through Jehaziel and said that he would not need to do anything but to praise, just to worship him, and to see that his hand will move over the lives of the people of Judah. So what I've come here to say is that we do not need to fight our own battles, for the battle belongs to the Lord. When we are faced with one thing or the other, with one struggle or the other, we need to believe and understand and put our faith in the Lord, that there is nothing that the enemy can do to us. Now, we learned today in church that a victory comes when we shift our focus from our struggles, from the things of the world. When we shift our focus from the things of the world to God himself, that's when victory comes. Who can stand against the Lord?
People desert him. Sometimes the friends of this world will desert you.
Oh, yes.
For you to rise up again, the friend of this world will desert you. You won't have any. Imagine that I gave you a story of what happens. They will say, the first question they will ask him, can you trust this your friend to a loaded gun? And you will see him standing up saying, no, sir, I can't. And they say, about turn. And he's going out. And you'll be looking at him, the person I brought to cover. The friends of this world will desert you. And Saul didn't know that. When they were going, they were all running away. He said, go and bring them. Let me do it. So that we can seek the face of the Lord. And he's not the right person to seek the face of the Lord. And as he has just finished. Oh, let's look at it. You might not open it, but I'll just read it because of our time. He says, Saul remained in Gilgal, and the troops with him were quickened with fear. He waited 7 days, and the time set by Samuel, but Samuel did not come to Gilgal. And Saul's men began to scatter. So he said, bring me the burnt offering and the fellowship offerings. And Saul offered up the burnt offering. Just as he finished making the offering, Samuel arrived. And Saul went out to greet him. And by his left said, what have you done? Asked Samuel. Saul replied, when I saw the men were scattering and that you did not come at the set time and that the Philistines were assembling at Mishmash, I thought now the Philistines will come down against me at Gilgal, and I have not sought the Lord's favor. So I felt compelled to offer the burnt offering. And verse 13 said, you acted foolishly. May we not act foolishly. If we are to rise again, believe you me, brothers and sisters, we should not act foolishly. There are some acts that are foolish. And he says, you acted foolishly, Samuel said. You have not kept the command the Lord your God had given you. If you had, he would have established your kingdom over Israel for all time. But now your kingdom will not endure. Your own kingdom will endure in the end of the age. So, if one doesn't have patience, he can mar somebody's life. He can make someone to remain where he is and not rise up. But you rise up in the name of Jesus. And if you look at John 11:21, he says, if you have been here, my brother will not have died. Both of them, they echo it. They repeated it. Martha said it. Mary said it. God, he knew the supremacy of Christ. If you had been here, my brother wouldn't have died. What Martha was telling Jesus Christ is very simple. What Mary was telling Jesus Christ, you are too late. Thank you very much. You are too late. We sent for you. Bethany is just later 2 miles. He's a walking distance about 30 minutes. At most 40 minutes. And you will have been here. But if you have been here, my brother would have been in that grave. If you have been here, my brother would not have died. Why did you wait so long? Lord, we don't understand why you waited so long. But his ways are God's way, and not yours or mine. And it isn't great if it's 4 days late, he's still on time. If it's 4 days late, he's still on time.
Amen.
Lord, we don't understand why you waited so long. You waited for 4 days. We told you, we sent a message. He's sick. But you waited. And Jesus Christ waited for 4 days. 4 days. That is 24 hours in a day.
Times four.
Times it by the 60 minutes. Times it by the 60 seconds. I don't know mathematics to that level. Praise the Lord. So, Lord, we don't understand why you waited so long. But his ways are God's ways. And not your own ways or my own way. It's not your ways or my ways. He can decide to do what he wants to do. But as long as he's a supreme God, and you know the supremacy of Christ, you rest assured in him. Why you waited so long? Lord, we don't understand why you waited so long. His ways are God's ways, and not yours or mine. And it isn't great If it's 4 days late, it's still on time. Even if it is 4 days late, it's still on time. If it is 1 year late, it's still on time. If it is 5 years late, it's still on time. Some people, they will say their wombs are closed. It's still on time. Anything that you are passing through is still on time. John 11:22 say, but I know that even now, God will give you whatever you ask. That statement is not a statement of faith. It's a prophetic statement. Hallelujah. May God make prophecy to come out of your mouth. In the name of Jesus Christ. Our man of God said it here. He said he looked at his son. The son was crying. And he prophesied into his life. Look, you may not go to that place they are going today. Forget about it. But you will travel all over the whole world. And that prophetic come to pass. That is a prophetic utterance. He says, I know. Even now, God will give you whatever you ask. It's a prophetic statement. He has faith already in Christ. We shouldn't stop prophesying into things that we think they are dead. Prophesy into it. Don't worry. Just prophesy. And you see what God is going to do. And John 11:20 says, Jesus said to her, your brother will rise again. That is the theme. Your brother will rise again. You will rise again. By this time next year, you are coming with a prophetic, with a testimony of rising up again. And people will hear that testimony. It will be a bountiful testimony. In the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus is telling us today we will rise again. Whatever what our afflictions may be, our downtrodden, whatever what it may be, whatever what position we may have been, whatever what sickness or diseases we are having, we will rise up again. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. You might be fighting a battle of fear. You cry to the Lord and he can help, but he has not shown up. Don't lose courage, my brother. Don't lose faith. He's a supreme God. The God yesterday, the same is he today, and tomorrow forevermore. Amen. In conclusion of this teaching, John 3:16 said one thing. It said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only and one son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. When we don't know who Christ is, what happens to us is that we believe this world is all what we have. This life is all what we have. But we don't know who Christ is. It's like, oh, this life is all what I have. This life is all what I'm going to live with. That is not so, my brother. This life is just the introduction to a life that is to come.
Hallelujah.
This life that we are living is an introduction to the life to come. I don't bloody care. If you don't have anything, don't worry. It's just an introduction to the life that is to come. It's an introduction to eternity. To believe is more than intellectual agreement that Jesus is Lord. To believe in him means to put our trust and confidence in him. That only him alone can save us. It's to put Christ in charge of everything. Our present life and our eternal hope. Our present life today and our eternal plans. Our plans today and our eternal life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And that is the supremacy and the being friend of Christ. Let us rise up. His ways are God's way. Are not yours or mine. And it isn't great if he's 4 days late, he's still on time. He went to the place, he gave thanks to the Lord Almighty, and he called Lazarus. Your name will be called in the name of Christ. Whatever what affliction you are passing through, whatever what you are passing through, whatever seems to have held you down for long, Jesus You will rise up again. In the name of Jesus Christ. You will rise up again. In the name of Jesus Christ. I want us to do two prayers. Number one, Lord Jesus, I want you to be my friend. A good number of people, they know Jesus. They don't. They just know Jesus on the point of, I am a Christian. That is the point they know Jesus Christ. But know Jesus Christ as your friend. Pray, pray, pray. Acknowledge the supremacy, the supreme power above all other power.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
In Jesus' name we pray. Now prophesy on yourself and your children, on your children, on yourself, on your loved one, on your ministries. Whatever is representing Lazarus in your life, that you thought and you believe every hope is gone, to rise up again in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Almighty. God is good.
The ministers who have given us the word from Jubilee Christian Church International Zion's Chapel. And we have a pastor here as well from Jubilee Life International Ministry. Praise the Lord. That is Pastor Vincent Babatola. And Baba, today I want you to come and pray for the pastor of Jubilee Christian Church International. Right from Jubilee Life International to pray for Jubilee Christian Church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 When our father was ministering there, my mind went straight to Ezekiel 37. Not only were they risen, but they became an army.
Amen.
And they were marching.
Amen.
And they became victorious.
Amen.
So we're going to speak to the life of our father. That as a minister of God, he will stand.
Amen.
He will march.
Amen.
Victorious.
Amen.
And the Zion Jubilee Christian Church of the Zion Chapel, as long as the sun and the moon endure it throughout all generations, people will worship them. Father, we just bless you for your son that has come here this evening to show forth your supremacy. He dwelt on your person. Father, we did not hide who you are. He revealed to us who you are. You are the friend worthy. You are the one that show forth the invisible God. From you we can see God. Our Father, we bless you. Because the word of your son this evening elevates you, edifies you. And so we pray that you will edify, you will elevate, you will glorify your son and his ministry and his wife and all that pertain to you. Father, you become the new wife in his ministry. You will speak, Father. Your word will not fall to ground. You will trust him to be honored. In Jesus' name. Everlasting Father, we are blessed today. Father, your word indeed is a lamp unto our feet,
yes,
and a light unto our path.
Like
Father, you said that blessed are those who did not dignify, who did not undignify you. Your son showed us this evening that indeed you are supreme.
Yes.
And he links us even back to number 6, where he says, may the Lord bless you and keep you. We see the face of the Lord. Even as far as numbers. But Colossians now shows further that indeed you are the face of the invisible God. Who have seen you have seen God. Through your son this evening, those of us who don't even know God before begin to know that when Jesus Christ is there, God is there. Father, honor in Jesus' name. Because Father, Lord, he has unveiled that which has been hidden in the past. To some people who do not even know that Christ is God. This evening he has shown forth. That's the area he went to first. Your supremacy, that you create all things created in the heaven and the earth were done by you and for your glory. Because Lord, he has elevated you, elevate him on his
own.
Because he has edified, cause him to be edified. Father, because he has honored you wherever he goes, wherever the Jubilee Christian Church, Zion Chapel gathers. Father, honor them there in Jesus' name. And Lord, he has spoken to our life this evening. And collectively, Lord, we have spoken this life. That every snare that is binding him and his family, we are broken tonight.
Amen.
Because your word said the snare is broken and we escape. Father, even the song that was sung to us is in that as we praise, as we worship, all chains are broken.
Amen.
All chains that is in his mind, be broken tonight.
Amen.
And he's free in Jesus' name. Because the Bible says, Lord, that who the Son of Man has set free is free indeed. Now your son is free.
Amen.
His family is free.
Amen.
Everyone that worship under his voice is free in Jesus' name. And as we have declared liberty for us, because Father, it's for liberty that you have set us free. Everything that is holding us bound this evening, because we have gathered, as we declare in John 11:23, we are free indeed.
Amen.
The cloak of death is taken away.
Amen.
The cloak of sorrow is taken
Amen.
Away. Nothing is holding us down.
Amen.
We are liberated.
Amen.
And Christ Living Church is liberated.
Amen.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Christ Living Church is liberated. Now, when we will come back next year, this place will be greater.
Amen.
We hold you the Son to the declaration of your Son. Your next year, our Father here will not be able to recognize everyone.
Amen.
Because this church itself will have grown.
Amen.
Part of this recognition is going on is because we are still few. Father, multiply your church.
Amen.
And like your ministry.
Amen.
By the time we come, that you will bring the glory.
Amen.
Because when you shine, Father, he said, the new Jerusalem, that there's no light there because you are the light. When you are shining in this place, none of us will be glorified.
Amen.
None of us will be recognized. It's all whatever your supremacy. Father, in Thanksgiving Church, in our Lord, our churches, it didn't even go. In the center of our church, thank you, Holy Spirit, because we will do more than we ask for. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, sir. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Can we have our seat, please? Recognize the presence of all our guests. We have Prophetess Agnes Noamis. God bless you. Thanks for coming. We have Pastor Adeyinka Noamis. God bless you. Thanks for coming. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We have our sister Titi in our midst. And Titi O.O. And God bless you, man. Thanks for coming. This is where we do in Jesus' name. And our pastor is going to come back again because we need to give an offering. So I want you to come and take the offering, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
One thing I love in every service I want to see you is offering. And why do I love offering? Because our father referred to it in his sermon, John 3:16. For God so loved the world, he did. If you love the Lord, you want to give. If I'm having my birthday, I receive bountiful things because people love me. But this is the Lord's day. It's the Lord's. And for all good and perfect, it comes from him. So whatever we have, he's giving us. It's time for you and me. Last year, you will not just give tonight. You will tie your giving to a prayer point. Our daddy here was talking about Anna Shiloh. Anna Shiloh, there was a prayer attached to a promise. If God give me this child, this male child, I will bring him back. She brought him back. You want to say, Lord, I'm not giving to Pastor Akiye. I'm giving to Jesus Christ because we've learned that he's the supreme God. Hallelujah. Amen. And if he's the supreme God, you want to bless him. And you want to now attach his Lord, as I give you this, I want to be blessed. Hezekiah received a debt notice. Go on, Isaiah, go and tell him he's going to die. And he faced God, why will I die? I've been doing your will. So you will tie it and God said, get back Isaiah, tell him he's not going to die. So you want to give, you want to sow, so that by next anniversary, when God will have enlarged the coast of his ministry and expand it beyond this place, amen? You want God to enlarge your ministry, to enlarge your post. So giving today is not under compulsion. I can tell you all, I can cajole you. If you do this, you do this. But we're talking about giving to God. Everything we have, our life, our families, the good thing, the good health, the hope that we have, our dreams, our ambition, our expectation, is can only be realized by God. Therefore, dig into your pocket. I even want to challenge you. If what is in your pocket is inadequate, because you are before God, give what you have now and make a resolution in your heart. I don't want to write an IOU because we don't want to chase you. But make a resolution in your heart that you will send forward the balance to this ministry. It's a pledge between you and God. It's a vow between you and God. So pray to God now. God, direct me in my giving. I want to tell him, direct me in my giving. Father, touch my heart. I learned that you are supreme. My finance is inadequate. I thought I'm going to buy an Ulster card. And if I give beyond what I have now, that Ulster card might not be possible. But I've learned that you are supreme. That you multiply grace. That you are resurrection and life. My finance needs your touch. Whatever you want now, tell God. And Father, I want to come back next year to give testimony. A family just left who gave a testimony. I want to be the one that will share the testimony next year based on this offering. A man's gift will make way for him. Speak to your gift now. That this is what I've brought, Lord. I brought this. Let's lift our envelopes. I brought this. The people, the Magi, they came from the east. They brought gifts. We saw his stars in the east. I and we have come to worship him. They didn't come empty-handed. If you have come to worship the Lord, lift up your envelope. Thank you, Father, for the faith that your children have in you. Thank you, Father, for the spirit of obedience. They have not come to your house empty-handed. Thank you, Father, because as you give to the sower, so you give. You give bread and you give to the, you give seed. Father, they have bread, they have seed. They have roof over their heads. They have good earth. It's your doing. Thank you in particular for those who worship in this ministry. Thank you that throughout the year from last year till now, they've never lacked. Thank you that they are gainfully employed in this ministry. Thank you, Father, that disaster has not knocked on their doors. Thank you that they are not victim of accident or terror. I'm so, Lord, this is a thanksgiving giving for them. For us, who are guests, we are just giving an anniversary giving unto you. Father, together, receive them in Jesus' name. Father, together, sanctify them in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, you are able to do more than we can give. Father, because we are giving in obedience, Father, reach down and multiply our thoughts. Multiply all our pockets. Father, take away devourer from our finances. Take away all manner of devourer. Things that could lead to God curses, could lead to disease, take it away from our lives. And our giving today, Father, Lord, let it pave way for us. In a new week, let it pave way for us. Even as we look forward to the last 3 months of this year, let this offering, Father, Lord, pave way for us. For your church, teach us how to use it. Father, Lord, multiply for love. The needs are great. But this food that has been brought today, Father, as you did to the widow of Zarephath, let it be multiplied. So that as long as from now to next year, this ministry will not lack. They will not lack the rent to pay. They will not lack the means to pay their rent, to meet all the needs of this ministry. Far above, you will do. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus. Everybody say, eyes haven't seen.
Eyes haven't seen.
Ears haven't heard.
Ears haven't heard.
No heart has conceived. What the Lord has in store for me. So as we start this scene and as we sing this song, let us do it with faith that he will do a new thing. Amen.
Amen.
Eyes haven't seen and ears haven't heard the kind of blessings, the kind of blessings that's about to fall on me.
And if your giving has not been enough, you give more. God is telling me that my own giving was not enough, but added more. I don't know who else, someone, if there's God has spoken to someone. He spoke to me. I'd already enveloped, and he says, no, go back, and convey it. I don't know if anyone, it's not a matter of being possible. And I didn't do that because I'm going to get anything out of it. Just looking to know that God speaks in this place. Father, we bless you. Of time, God came in form of a man. That's what our Father was saying, that they are never late. So, Father, those who are giving today, bless them in Jesus.
Yes.
Those who are pledging their spirit to add more to what they've given, or to even bring more in terms of cash or kind, Father, even now, receive it with joy in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Father, for those who are giving their time and their ministry towards this anniversary, Father, we raise them up unto you.
Amen.
Father, bless them abundantly.
Yes.
Father, we pray that those who sow today, because nobody cannot give you, they will be abundantly blessed and surprised in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The last 3 months of this year, Father Lord, let the grace that is in it surpass what has been there in the last 9 months of the year. Father, cause their joy to overflow. Cause their blessing to be in abundance. Above all, Lord, let your knowledge cover this land. In Jesus' name.
Is not very far from you, we can join us to worship. And God Almighty Father, we bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It shall be well with you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Well, this is all our program for the week, even towards the end of the year. Prayer meetings on Wednesday, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. We have our Sunday school service, 11 to 1 p.m. every Sunday. And every last Friday of each month, we have a night vigil. And God Almighty has proven Himself in our life. Praise the Lord. We have a forthcoming event. It is Carol on the 21st of December this year. You can join us to celebrate with Christ and shall be well with you in Jesus' name. And towards the end of the year, we know we need to fast and pray, because I know that 2019 is a great year.
Amen.
We need to claim it. We have to fast and pray and kneel before the Almighty God that and prophesy to that year. That year will be your year in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It shall be well with you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are to bring the service to a close now. When we started on Friday, the pastor who started with us is hereby present. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And you can see Friday, Saturday and Sunday, it was very beautiful. They started with us and go to give us a closing prayer and do the grace, and we shall be well with us. That's the person of Pastor Akonde. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Psalm 126. You have your Bible. Psalm 126. I will read it. I can't, for those who haven't got their Bible with them. And as I read it, let the word minister to you so that you pick which one you want to pray about. It says, when the Lord brought back the captivity of Isaac upon him, that is my household, we were like those who dream. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, and our tongue with singing. Then they said among the nations, that the people out there, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us in my household. And we are glad. Bring back our captivity, O Lord, as the streams in the south. Those who sow in tears shall reap in joy.
Amen.
He who continually goes forth weeping, bearing seed for sowing, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. The Lord is saying that because of this conference, because you are here, and as many as have attended in the last 3 days, whether they are here now or they are not, the Lord is turning your captivity.
Amen.
Because grave is a place of captivity. And when God sets you free, we are today the one who has the power to set free. His name is Jesus.
Amen.
We had the same yesterday. His name is Jesus.
Amen.
We had the same day before yesterday. His name is Jesus.
Amen.
And he's here in our midst. And he's setting you free.
Amen.
He's setting me free.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
A couple came today and gave a testimony. And for some of us who have been going through those kind of troubles, maybe at work, maybe in the courtroom. Their one was in the courtroom. And the Crown Court is the highest court in the land, where they can put you in jail for as long as possible. But those couple, look at what the woman said. God, she has never saw that Bible before. And God said, go and take that Bible, a children's Bible, and look at Isaiah 50, verse 7. And do you see what is in there? You're going to pray to God. Turn my captivity.
Amen.
Tonight, as we end this, let it be like I am dreaming over this matter. Whatever the circumstances, let it be like I have been dreaming about this. Is this a dream? That you have turned everything around for my good. That you have turned my ministry around. That you have turned my business around. That you have turned this sickness into joy. That you have turned this problem at work. Is this how God works? We have people say they have buried me. As you did for those couple who gave a testimony. You told, the word says, you will help them. And you help them. The word says you will fight that battle in court for them. And you fought the battle. You turn everything around. That in every area where I remain in captivity. Before I leave right now, this place, turn my captivity. Put my enemy to shame. Lord Jesus Christ, the word says that you came out from the grave. You put to shame powers and principalities. You make a public show of them. Daddy, make a public show of all my enemies. Make a public show of lack so that you take me out of lack. Take me out of poverty into your abundance. Release me from captivity. Form of captivity. Release my wife, release my children, release my family from any and every form of captivity right now in the name of Jesus Christ, that you alone may be glorified. Let people begin to seek and to say, what has God has done great things for me? Of the world see and they begin to glorify you, because when they say God has done great things, means they are glorifying you. Let them glorify you because of me, because of my family, because of my business, because of my ministry. Let them glorify you and let my joy be full. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Second prayer point you are going to take from there. Is this? Those who sow in tears shall reap in joy. He who continually goes forth weeping, bearing seed for sowing, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. We're going to pray for this ministry, Christian Living Church, and for every church, every ministry that is represented here, and that has been represented in the last 3 days. They have been sowing. The time has come to reap. Let God now release grace for reaping. In the name of Jesus Christ, we go pray that every church, use the Christ Living Church as a point of contact, that they begin to reap. And yes, reap with joy, reap with joy, reap with joy. A sheaf of harvest. In the name of Jesus Christ, bountiful, bountiful, bountiful harvest. That they have sown for it. The time has come. This is the time. In the name of Jesus Christ, who is standing? That has preached in these last 3 days, there's no preaching that is like the other one. It can only be you. It can only be you. You put your words in the mouth of your servant. Even every minister who has prayed in the pulpit in the last 3 days, you put different words in their mouth, because you are God and you will always be God. Daddy, we appreciate you. He said, thank you for what you have done for us in this place, that you have not left Christ Living Church, neither have you forsaken them, because you are their God. You are the God over this church. Lord Jesus, you said, I will help you. And so we release them into the help of the Almighty God.
Amen.
Daddy, stretch forth your hand to help them.
Amen.
Stretch forth your hand to lift up your church.
Amen.
Stretch forth your hand to build this church.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let it be well with them.
Amen.
That God begin to enlarge their host.
Amen.
In every area.
Amen.
Spiritually.
Amen.
Financially.
Amen.
In numbers.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That in this church your name will continually be glorified.
Amen.
Only Jesus will be preached.
Amen.
Only Jesus will suffer.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Daddy, we thank you.
Amen.
Daddy, we commit everyone in this place to your holy hand. Daddy, you know our hearts. You know what we have prayed for. And your word is yea and nay. It's never nay. It's yea and amen. That is, you said whatever you hear us say with our mouth, that is what you will do. And so concerning each one, we have prayed, and I agree with them, that you will do that which concerns them. You will perfect it to the glory of your name. When they come next year, they will come and give testimony.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
There shall be a time of testimony.
Amen.
Lord, there shall be a time of testimony.
Amen.
You will do it and speedily. Speedily.
Amen.
Speedily.
Amen.
That Lord, even before this month is out, people will begin to come to the pastor.
Amen.
And say, Lord, God has done this.
Amen.
God has done my captivity.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I have risen again. And I'm rising again.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, we thank you. Blessed be your holy name. Daddy, we want to thank you for all the ministers who have ministered. Daddy, we give you glory, honor, and adoration for their lives. We give give you glory for all those who minister in songs, in praises, Daddy, throughout these 3 days. Daddy, it has been your doing. Daddy, we have nothing to give them in terms of money, but you are the rewarder of those who diligently serve you. Daddy, we ask that you will reward them.
Amen.
Reward them, Father.
Amen.
Reward them, Father.
Amen.
Let their joy be full.
Amen.
Those who minister to you in song, Daddy, enlarge their goals.
Daddy,
let their songs be pleasing unto you.
Amen.
Daddy, as you rejoice in their worship, in their praises that they have led us, Daddy, look on them from heaven.
Amen.
Pour out your oil of Gilead.
Amen.
That which concerns them, Daddy, perfect it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And charge amongst them. There are those who are seeking your face for a life partner. Daddy, by the time we come next year, Daddy, do that which is their own.
Amen.
Give them the bones of their bones.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
If they are not married by next year, let them find the right one for them.
Amen.
So that, Lord, it should be a question of time.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Daddy,
praise the Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ,
by
your presence this evening, breathe unto us in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your word come alive in our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. We will rise up again in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, everlasting dear Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. And amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
To see yet another anniversary.
Glory.
Since last year, this is another anniversary, and we are grateful to God Almighty. And I want to acknowledge the shepherd in charge of this assembly, the Christ Living Church, has been a true man of God, walking in the ways of the Lord Almighty. God will honor you in the name of Jesus Christ for giving us the opportunity to speak the word. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And then I want to thank and I want to acknowledge all the great men of God that are here that this little me want to speak in your presence. We pray that God Almighty will hearken unto this word and let your word also be fulfilled in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. And I want to thank very most importantly my wife. She has always been my support. She has always been there for me. And we are here together. Praise the Lord. Amen. I want to sing a song. I want us all to sing that song. It says, I live for Jesus day after day. I live for Jesus. Say what come me, Holy Spirit, I will obey. I live for Jesus day after day. Day after day, I live for Jesus day after day. I live for Jesus. Say what come me, Holy Spirit, I will obey. I live for Jesus day after day. I live for Jesus day after day. Amen. text of this particular year of I'll rise up again comes from John chapter 11, verse 23. And for clarity purpose, I want us to just read the chapter 11, and then from verse 1 to 44. I will read quickly, but I want us to please go along with us because of our time. That we'll see. I want us to see what happened there before we go into it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
John chapter 11. John chapter 11 from verse 1 to 44. Now, a man named Lazarus was sick. He was from Bethany, the village of Mary and her sister Martha. This Mary, whose brother Lazarus was lay sick, was the same one who poured perfume on the Lord and wiped his feet with her hair. So the sister sent word to Jesus, "Lord, the one you love is sick." When he heard this, Jesus said, "This sickness will not end in death. No, it is for God's glory, so that God's Son may be glorified through it." Verse 5, Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. Yet when he heard that Lazarus was sick, he stayed where he was 2 more days. Verse 7 said, then he said to his disciples, "Let us go back to Judea." "But Rabbi," they said, "a short while ago the Jews tried to stone you, and yet you are going back there." Jesus answered, "Are there not 12 hours of day? A man who walks by day will not stumble, for he sees by this world's light." And verse 10 says, "It is when he walks by night that he stumbles, for he has no light." After he had said this, he went on to tell them, "Our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep, but I am going there to wake him up." His disciples replied, "Lord, if he sleeps, he will get better." Jesus has been speaking of his death, but his disciples thought he meant natural sleep. So then he told them plainly, "Lazarus is dead, and for your sake I am glad I was not there, so that you may believe, but let us go to him." In verse 16 says, "Then Thomas, called the Didymus, said to the rest of the disciples, 'Let us also go, that we may die with him.'" Verse 17, "On his arrival, Jesus found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Bethany was less than 2 miles from Jerusalem, and many Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them in the loss of their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went out to meet him, but Mary stayed at home. Verse 21, "Lord," Martha said to Jesus, "if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now God will give you whatever you ask." And verse 23, Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." So everyone here, by the grace of Almighty God, you will rise again.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Verse 24 says, "Martha answered, 'I know he will rise again in the resurrection at the last day.' And Jesus said to her, 'I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die.'" Do you believe this?
Yes.
27, "Yes, Lord," she told him. "I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who was come into the world." And after she had said this, she went back and called her sister Mary aside. "The teacher is here," she said, "and she's asking for you." When Mary heard this, she got up quickly and went to him. Now, Jesus had not yet entered the village, but was still at the place where Martha had met him. When the Jews who had been with Mary in the house, comforting her, noticed how quickly she got up and went out, they followed her, supposing she was going to the tomb to mourn here. And verse 32 says, "When Mary reached the place where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said, 'Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died.' And 33, when Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who had come along with her also weeping, he was deeply moved in spirit and troubled. 34, 'Where have you laid him?' he asked. 'Come and see, Lord,' they replied." And the shortest verse in the Bible says, "Jesus wept." That is 35. Jesus wept. Then the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, Could not he who have opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying? Verse 38, Jesus once more deeply moved, came to the tomb. It was a cave with stone laid across the entrance. Take away the stone, he said. But Lord, said Martha, the sister of the dead man, by this time there is a bad odor, for he has been there 4 days. And Jesus said, did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? So they took away the stone. And Jesus looked up and said, Father, I thank you that you have heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I said this for the benefit of the people standing here, that they may believe that you sent me. When he said this, Jesus called in a loud voice, Lazarus, come out! The dead man came out, his hands and feet wrapped with strips of linen and a cloth around his face. Jesus said to them, take off the grave clothes and let him go. All the graves not today here will be taken up. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Why I decided to read the whole of that place is for us to have an understanding of what happened there. Without us having an understanding of what happened there, it may be difficult to understand the real clarity of I will rise again. That team, I will rise again. I want to speak on two issues, on two things concerning our rising. If we are to understand our rise up again, I want to speak on two things. And the third thing is we will just pray. The first thing I'm going to speak about is the supremacy of Christ.
Hallelujah.
The supremacy of Christ. That's the first thing I'm going to speak about. And the second thing is Christ being our friend. And if Christ is our friend, what are those constant things that we must take care of if Christ is to be our friend? The first thing is the supremacy of Christ. The second, Christ being our friend. And what are those things that we must take cognizance of if Christ is our friend? And what are those things that we must take cognizance of? And we pray. Amen. In speaking about the supremacy of Christ, let us look quickly at Colossians chapter 1 from verse 15 to 20. Colossians chapter 1 from verse 15 to 20. 15, he said, he is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. For by him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or powers or rulers or authorities. All things were created by him and for him. 17 says, he is before all things, and in him all things hold together. And he is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning and the firstborn from among the dead, so that in everything he might have the supremacy. For God was pleased to have all his fullness dwell in him, and through him to reconcile to himself all things, whether things on earth or things in heaven, by making peace through his blood shed on the cross. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The supremacy of Christ. If we are to understand our rise again, we have to first know the supremacy of Christ. Who is Christ? If we don't know the supremacy of Christ, it's difficult for us to rise again. Very, very difficult. It becomes a very difficult thing for anybody that is down to rise up again if you don't know the supremacy of Christ. Praise the Lord. That's why I want to speak especially on this one, supremacy of Christ, for us to know the supremacy of Christ as it is written in that place. Something as the pastor, as a pastor was introducing the members, the guests, and the men of God that are here, something came into my mind that there's going to be a time you will not be able to introduce everybody.
Amen.
so shall he be in the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. This is the strongest statement that has ever been said anywhere in the Bible. Colossians chapter 1, 15 to 20. It's the strongest statement that tells us about the divine nature of who Christ is. It's the strongest statement in the Bible. If you search the whole Bible, that Colossians chapter 1 from verse 15 to 20 tells us about the divine nature of Christ. And if we look at it, I put one as, Jesus is the image of the invisible God. That means, is the visible likeness of the invisible God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The visible likeness of the invisible God. This was Jesus who came here on earth. And nobody has ever seen God before. But because of the fact that it is written, and every one of us can see it, we have read it times without number that Jesus Christ was here on earth. He is the visible image of the invisible God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You have to understand the supremacy of Christ. If you don't understand it, to rise up again becomes difficult. And people will be looking at you where you are and saying, will we rise up again? Except you know, except you understand the supremacy of Christ. Praise the Lord. The second of it says, is the exact representation of God. The exact representation of God. Means here is the exact representation of God. The medicine of this world, there are a lot of things that do happen. They do a lot of things, research and all this. There was a time they came up with something, they say clone. Mm-hmm. They say there's a clone. And when they do cloning, if you see a mark in this place, you see a mark in the clone. Anything that is cloned, you see exact representation of what is cloned. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So you see that Jesus Christ is the exact representation of God here on earth. Is the exact resemblance of God here on earth. The third one is, not only did he reflect God, he reveals God to us. Not only did he reflect who God is, not only did he chose all the image of God, he reveals, he made known who God is to us. He made it known to us. It's the Jesus Christ who made it known to us. John chapter 10 verse 30, you might just write it down. I and the Father are one. He said that. And John chapter 1 verse 18 says, no one has ever seen God. No one has ever seen God. The only Son, who is the same as God, and is at the Father's side, he has made him known. And that is Jesus Christ. And I love this place so much. John 14. Just write those ones down. When you get home, you can just peruse it and look at it. John chapter 14, verse 6 to 14. He said, Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. Three things are there. I am the way, the truth, and the life. If you are to rise again, you must know who the way is. You must know the truth. And then the life of rising up will come upon you. So he says, I am the life. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. It's not possible. There is nobody that can come to the Father except through the image, the real representation of the Father. Nobody. It's not possible. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And no one comes to the Father except through me. And verse 7 says, if you really knew me, you will know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. If you know me, don't worry. Don't bother about the Father. You have seen the Father. And verse 8 is very funny. He says, Philip said, Lord, show us the Father and that will be enough for us. See, Philip has been a disciple of Jesus Christ. He has been going with Jesus Christ. But yet he doesn't know who Jesus Christ is. He doesn't know the Father. He was asking from me, he said, please, can you show us the Father? That it will be all enough for us. And so you find a lot of us here call ourselves Christians. We don't know who Christ is. I'm sorry to say, some of us don't know the supremacy of Christ. We go about by the name of, when they say, can you feel your religion here? Everybody writing Christianity, Christianity, Christianity. But we don't know who Christ is. And if you see the reply Jesus Christ said, that place is interesting. And Jesus answered verse 9, don't you know me, Philip? Philip, you don't know me. Even after I've been among you for such a long time. Philip, even after I've been with you for such a long time, you don't even still know me. You are looking for the Father. You are asking me, show us the Father. Except to move the supremacy of Christ, to rise up will become difficult. You might even be going every day. People might be looking at you and be like, why? But you don't know the supremacy of Christ. You don't know who Christ is. And that's why Christ was looking at Philip, saying, Philip, Philip, even after I've been among you for such a long time, anyone who has seen me, look at it, has seen the Father. If you see me as Christ, you have seen the Father. How can you say you show us the Father? Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Except you know the supremacy of Christ, you know that Father is in you and He is there and you are in the Father, to rise up becomes difficult. But we will rise up in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
We will never be the same in the name of Jesus. You will rise up today in the name of Jesus. And another one is, this same Jesus Christ we are talking about, I will not read to, I will just leave it for that verse 10. He's the firstborn of all, over all creation. He existed before anything. He existed. He's the firstborn of every creation, over all creation. And the next one is, He's completely holy.
Amen.
He's completely holy.
Amen.
If you get home, just read, just write it there, Hebrews 7, 26 to 27. And another one is, He has authority to judge the world. God will judge men's secret through Jesus Christ. Whether we like it or not, He's going to be the judge. He's going to judge men's secret. Whatever what we do in the closet of, is God, is Jesus Christ is going to judge them. God is going to judge this world, me, you, everybody, through Jesus Christ. And if you know that, you know the supremacy of Christ. And another one is, Christ is the firstborn among the dead. Jesus was raised from dead and His resurrection proved His lordship over the material world. All who trust in Christ will also defeat death. Somebody will defeat death.
Amen.
Today in the name of Jesus Christ. And rise again to live.
Amen.
And rise again to live eternally with Him. 1 Thessalonians 4:14. He said we believe that Jesus died and rose again. And so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in Him. Amen. That is the supremacy of Christ. Therefore, Christ is supreme over all creation, including all the spirit world. And that's why sometimes people be saying principalities and power. Let's start praying about principalities and power. You have something who is supreme over principality and power. That is it. He's supreme over principalities and power. You see, one thing that says, including all the spirit world, whatever where they may be seated, anywhere they may have been, he's supreme over them. So our Christian faith must not be hollow. You see, one thing that is very painful and that is baffling is that we find out that our Christian faiths are very, very hollow. They are, there's a substance there. Without substance, it's hollow. It's shallow. So I can put it by being shallow. Without substance. Our Christian faith must not be without substance. It must not be hollow. Because when you look at that, you see a lot of example going on in the world. There was a time WhatsApp message was going up and down. And they said, somebody was asking, Alexa, who is Jesus Christ? And Alexa would say, I don't know. They said, Google, who is Jesus Christ? They said, I don't know.
He said, I'm sorry about that. They say, who is Buddha? Google will tell you who Buddha is. Who is Muhammad? Google will tell you who Muhammad is. Google, who is Jesus Christ? I'm sorry, you can ask that again. I don't understand. Because some of us, our Christian faiths are very hollow. It's without substance. Jesus Christ that we are talking about is the supreme over all those ones. Supreme over all those. So, we must not allow all those small, small things. That's what they are using. Technology is trying to take a lot of people away from Christianity today. And our faith is becoming hollow. It's misdirected. And doesn't have a substance. And it's meaningless. So, our Christian faith must be standing on the word of God. It must be standing on the word of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is not merely a prophet or a good teacher. Jesus is Lord of the glory of the Father. Christ has no equal and no rival. He is the Lord of all. He has no equal. There used to be a secondary school motto of a in my town in those days. You know, all these schools they have motto, and it's out of Latin. They bring it out of Latin. And that school, they say, is nullius secundum. Nullius secundum means second to none. And when you say something is second to none, it's first. Jesus is nullius secundum. Whether you like it or not, there is not, nobody can take his first position.
Amen.
Because of Christ, is spiritually supreme in the universe. Surely we should give him the first place in all our thoughts and our
glory.
We should give him the first place.
Hallelujah.
And that marks the end of that supremacy. You must first know the supremacy of Christ before you can talk about rising up again. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Having this knowledge of the supremacy of Christ, we will now look at it, Christ being our friend. That is the major one. Christ being our friend. And if Christ is our friend, what are those things that we must take cognizance of? There are a lot of things that we must take cognizance of, but I will just mention some few. But before we go to that place, we should know that we will all rise up again. Nothing will hold us down.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Because we now know the supremacy of Christ. We know the power that Christ is carrying. And we know what makes us to be a Christian. Then, now, we want to talk about Christ being our friend. Before we go to that, I will just say about five characters of a very close friend, a true friend. When you say somebody is a true friend, what are those characters? One, a true friend rejoices in your joy and sorrow over your pain. He rejoices in your joy, he sorrows over your pain. Not ordinarily is he sympathetic, but is also empathetic. A true friend, not ordinarily sympathetic, but is also empathetic. He put himself in your position. If you are passing through anything, he put himself there. And he's empathetic. Another one is, a true friend will stay in regular contact with you. Another one is, a true friend is someone you trust absolutely. Somebody you can trust absolutely. And each time I look at that place, before you can make somebody your friend, you see why Jesus Christ will be your friend today. Jesus Christ being our friend. Before you can make somebody to be your friend, you must trust him absolutely. And they say the people of this world are wise in their thinking. The people of the world. Do you know, I used to think about it. They say somebody you can trust. When we're in the military, I had the opportunity to serve in the military while in Nigeria. And sometimes when there's a problem, they want to court-martial you, and then you go for a disciplinary hearing or anything. They will tell you, bring somebody who is your friend who can vouch for you. Bring him along, and then you come. And what happened is when we go in for the training, everybody that has attended college, military war college or anything, the first thing when you go for arms competition, the first thing they are going to teach you as a military man is, look, anybody that is carrying a rifle or a pistol, that is loaded with a life ammo. Don't trust him. Even if it's your father, don't trust him. If it's your mother, don't trust him. That's the first thing they are going to teach you before you start the arms competition, before you start any arms training. So they have informed, everybody knows about that, everybody. Except you are not a military man, but if you are a military man, you know that even if it's your father that is carrying an arm, you look at it and say, this man. How can I trust this man? Loaded with life ammo. I can't trust this man. So they will tell you, the panel, about 16 men, they will say, come with your friend that can vouch for your character. And when you get to that place, you say, okay, people are sitting there. They say, are you the person? You say, how do you know him? You say, yeah, we were in line together. It was my classmate. It was this, okay. The first question they will ask him in your presence, can you trust him to a loaded gun? And you see the person that you brought. See, sometimes I look at that trust. It used to make me to laugh a lot. They will be the one to tell you, bring somebody that you know you trust that can vouch for your character. And when you get there, they are going to ask him a question that is going to defeat him. They say, okay, you know him very well. Say, can you trust him to a loaded gun, a life ammo? And you see your presence, you say no. That is the end of the case. But Jesus Christ, you can trust him. Amen. So, a true friend is someone you trust absolutely. Therefore, a true friend will stand by you and defend you. Even if it means taking bullets for you when you are under attack. If you hurt my friend, you hurt me. Another one is, a true friend won't cut you off because of disagreement. So that's just five things I just put there. So that from there, we'll be able to know whether Jesus Christ is a true friend or not. I just elicited those five things for us to know who our true friend should be. Is it the friend of this world or Jesus Christ is our friend?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
From where we read, Mary and Martha, their brother Lazarus was sick. In verse 3 of that chapter 11, we say, Lord, the one you love is sick. And in verse 11, Jesus himself confirming, saying, our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep. That shows that Lazarus is a friend of Christ. And the first lesson, if we are to rise again, the first lesson I want us to know is that if we are to rise up again, is to make Jesus Christ our friend.
Amen.
And the very, 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 very first person to turn to for them in times of need.
Amen.
The very first person to turn to for help as is the supreme being. Time will not permit me to start saying a lot of things, but I will just mention some things. You know that when you say somebody, you want to turn to somebody for help, that person must be somebody who absolutely be sure that this person will help me. In the Bible, there was a case of a king in the Bible, Ahaziah. Ahaziah is a son of Ahab. After the death of Ahab, Ahaziah reigned in his place. And something happened. Ahaziah fell from the lattice of the upper stairs where he was. In his palace. And when he fell down, he injured himself and he was sick, was ill. So he called his messengers, go to Ekron and go and ask the gods of Ekron, the Baal-Zebub of Ekron, whether I will get better from this illness. That is the person he turned to. He turned to that particular person. Say, go, messengers, go. Take message to the Baals in Ekron, the Baal-Zebub in Ekron, and ask whether I will get better from this illness. And as the messengers was going, they met with Elijah. And Elijah told him, he said, go back and tell him he will die. Is it because there's no God in Israel? That's why he's sorting for help from the Baal-Zebub. If we must rise up again, brothers and sisters, we must turn to God for them.
Hallelujah.
We must know that the first person to turn to for help is God. He said, go and tell him he's going to die. Because he thought there's no God in Israel. And he's turning to Baal-zebub. You little wonder, you reason with me, you turn to Baal-zebub. His own father and mother, Jezebel, they serve Baal all their lives. And possibly that's why he's turning to God. There is God.
Amen.
And Christ is supreme.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
So, when Mary and Martha, as their brother grew sick, the first thing they do was to turn to Jesus for help. Say, Jesus, your loved one, Lazarus, your loved one, is sick. So, that is the first person they turn to for help. May you turn to Jesus for help today.
Amen.
They believe in his ability to help because they have seen his miracles. So they know he can help. And so when we need an extraordinary help, Jesus provides an extraordinary solution.
Amen.
He has extraordinary resources.
Amen.
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 So, and when you look at it, Psalm 118, verse 8 to 9, say, it is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes. And if we look at our popular psalm, since when we were very young, Psalm 121, verse 1 and 2, he says, I will lift up my eyes unto thy hill. Where comes my help? Where comes my help? And verse 2 says, my help comes from the Lord, from the one who makes heaven and earth. If you are to rise up again, who is your helper? Who has been your helper? Who will be your helper? Jesus Christ is my helper. The King of Kings is my helper. The Lord of Lords is my helper. Obeninita, Keru Obeninita is my helper. Obanibani Olanilani is my helper. Obatotiwa Kayotowa is my helper. Obatio Mabenga Tayo is my helper. He is the King of Kings. He reigns supreme. If you make him your helper, you rise up again. If you turn to him for help, any situation, whatever it may be, turn to him. He'll be your helper. And John 11:4, when Jesus heard this, Jesus said, this sickness will not end in death. No, it is for God's glory. So that God's Son may be glorified through it. And sometimes when he ends in death, it's still for God's glory. I want us to know that sometimes when it ends up in death, it's still for God's glory. Why most Christians make mistake is that, you see, Jesus Christ says, I am the resurrection and the life. And back home, they coined some things back home. You know, people at home, they are very wise. Let me be. They said, it's the Bible too, but they use it. Now when you see any obituary that they say, Mama is sleeping. They won't say Mama is dead any longer. Baba is sleeping. Baba sleep on in the obituary. Because if he sleeps, he will wake.
Amen.
But if he's dead, that is the end of the whole story. But even if you die, there's still hope.
Hallelujah.
Do you know something used to baffle me when we were very young? We used to be farmers. We used to go to a farm with my parents, and my father loves. I don't shy away from it. I'm from a thick village. So when you plant corn, do you know what happened to it? You plant corn, you leave it there first day, second day, third day, maybe at the end of the fourth day, fifth day, you still it will shoot up. But do you know if you go to that corn before shooting up, the corn that is there is dead.
Yes. Yes.
Somebody will rise up. That corn is dead. Go and look. Anything that is planted will first die. Whether it's yam, whether it's anything, if you plant it first, the first thing that the first process is going to go through is dead. And that's why I said, somebody will rise up.
Amen.
Even if it ends up in death, it's to bring glory to God. So any trial a believer faces can ultimately bring glory to God, because God can bring good out of any bad situation. When trouble comes, do not grumble, complain, or blame God. Or do you see problem as opportunity? See God as opportunity to praise him.
Hallelujah.
see troubles as opportunity to honor him. John 11 verse 14. So Jesus told them plainly, Lazarus is dead. And for your sake, I'm glad I was not there, so that you may believe. If Jesus has been with Lazarus during the final moment of Lazarus' sickness, he might have healed him rather than let him die. But Lazarus died so that Jesus' power over death could be shown again and again and again and again. And if you look at what happened, the widow of Nain, the widow of Nain was going crying with the casket of the only child. Jesus showed the power over resurrection. Bring the coffin down. He was touched. Bring it down. Remember that the man there in the casket rose up again. You will rise up in Jesus' name.
Amen.
John 11:17. On his arrival, Jesus found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. If you look at verse 18 said that Bethany was just less than 2 miles from Jerusalem. Bethany. Less than two miles. And John 11:21 said, Lord, Martha said to Jesus, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. And Mary also repeated the same statement in John 11:32, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. So the second lesson we are to learn this afternoon is very, very important factor. If we must rise again, we must learn how to have patience. Most Christians, what is our problem? Our problem is not having patience. We want to go through the shortcut of the world. When Mary and Martha sent to Jesus Christ, your friend, the one you love, is sick. They leave it at that. They knew very well that the power rests on him. They didn't start to go. They didn't start to grumble. Why is he? He's not here. Bethany is just in that particular place. Most of us are saying, look, go and look for a car to go and bring him. If that is it. We want to cut short corners. But we must learn how to have patience. Sometimes in our life, we experience delay. That's why the fact that we have said a lot of things. That's why the fact that we are believing God on our prayers, we still experience delay. Don't forget that Bethany is just less than 2 miles. And Jesus Christ stayed for 4 days. less than two miles. It's a walkable distance, about 30 minutes to 40 minutes, at most 40 minutes. You must have patience. Delay is not denial. When you are passing through some facet of things in life, and you start looking at God, I've been praying about this, I've been doing this. Some people will say, let us pray. Pray until something happens. Push. No. You are going too far. I don't say it's not good to pray. That is not what I'm saying. But some people, they take it, it's because you don't know how to pray. It's because you don't know. God will be God every time.
Hallelujah.
He will reign supreme every time.
Amen.
So, delay is not denial. And Jesus Christ stayed for 4 days. He could show up, but he delayed. He purposely delayed. Human beings, and most especially those of us that are Christian, we don't want to wait. Most often, we assume that waiting is denial. And that is not the truth. That is not the truth thing. Waiting is not denial. I remember in our village, in those days, I told you, I said in the village, in those days, there used to be one man. I used to look at that man, I don't understand. Very old man. I don't know his age, but at least his hair is white. I don't know his age. But in those days in the village, where we were in the village, if you buy a rally bicycle, hey, everybody in the village will be coming to greet you. And they'll be looking at it. Rally bicycle. If you know what rally bicycle is, it's like our day's limousine, or whatever you call it. Rolls Royce. Rally bicycle. And that man, you know what interests me? He bought that rally bicycle. And he went and gave the rally bicycle to a sign writer. Please help me write something there. And they put it there. He said, I know Lua Kishu. He said, I know Lua Kishu. And you know one thing?
I don't even know. I'm just saying, throughout the period, I didn't see this man riding this bicycle. He bought the bicycle. He was, and you know, children were very frivolous. You will go and meet him. I don't want that. My father sent me a message to the next village. Can you please borrow me the bicycle? Because if you ride rally bicycle, you know what rally bicycle is. Oh, God of Israel. It's like you are riding on top of the wall. And we will quickly go and meet him. Very old man. You prostrate and say, Baba, Baba, no, Mr. Christ. My father sent me to the next village. Can you please borrow me bicycle? Go and carry it. Don't spoil it, though. So you will carry it and ride. He said, Ilya no lua. Somebody will rise up again. Yeah. If you know that patience is the watchword, that is the watchword. Most of us, we are in a hurry. Hurry going where? Hurry doing what? And I put it, I say, if this man will take this bicycle to a sign writer, I say, Ilya no lua. I didn't see him. But the rally bicycle was very beautiful. Bought it. He bought it with his own money. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Some of us, and most of the time, the consequences of not waiting can be very grievous. When we don't want to be patient, the consequences can be very grievous. And we don't know that the consequences could be very grievous. So, we want to do it ourselves. There are a lot of do-it-yourself now. Do-it-yourself, cut corners, shortcut. That is the most important thing. Shortcut. And by the time you take that shortcut, when you arrive, you may not even like it. Instead of going through the normal way. There's a story in the Bible of King Saul. You'll find that in 1 Samuel chapter 13, 7 to 14. You will not read it, but I'll just tell that story. Saul remained in Gilgal. He wants to go and face the Philistine. He's the king. He has been anointed. He's the king anointed by Samuel. And he's to face the Philistines. And he was in Gilgal. And the Philistines, they were getting up, getting ready. And there was a lot of rumor coming up and down. They are in mishmash. They are here. They are here. And the soldiers of Saul, they were about to desert him. They said, what is this man doing? Don't forget that they have just anointed Saul not too long. And people are looking at, how can this fellow be our king? This fellow. So, some of the soldiers were deserting him. They, why is he not making up his mind? And 7 days that Samuel gave to come and do his sacrifice has passed.
For children, Daddy, you said in your church, no one shall be barren. And so in this church, no one shall be barren.
Amen. Amen.
For them, Lord, bring them the bones of their bones. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Daddy, is there anyone among them whose career is not going as it should? That we decree they will rise.
Amen.
In their profession, they will rise.
Amen.
In their businesses, they will rise.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. By the perfect that which concerns
Amen.
Them. And let your name be glorified.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Daddy, we bring the one you have made the head of this church and his wife before you. Daddy, we lift them before the throne of mercy. We ask in the name that is above all names. That you will rest your hand upon them.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Rest your hand upon them.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Rest your hand upon them.
Amen.
In the mighty name
Amen.
Of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. We cry unto you, Father, that you will grant unto them the Spirit of God.
Amen.
The Spirit of wisdom.
Amen.
The Spirit of knowledge.
Amen.
The Spirit of understanding.
Amen.
The Spirit of counsel,
Amen.
The Spirit of might,
Amen.
The Spirit of power,
Amen.
And the Spirit of the fear of the Lord,
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
When all these are released unto them, they cannot fail.
Amen.
And I declare, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you shall not fail.
Amen.
You shall not fall.
Amen.
You shall not falter.
Amen.
You will rise.
Amen.
You will rise.
Amen.
The glory of God will rise upon
Amen.
You. In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Shine
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Because the glory of God comes upon you
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
People of every nation, they will begin to come.
Amen.
People of every nationality,
Amen.
They begin to come
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Princes and kings,
Amen.
Presidents and prime ministers,
Amen.
Ministers in business,
Amen.
Ministers in the security forces, they begin to come.
God. In the name of Jesus Christ. They will bring the wealth of nations to you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So shall it be. Your door will be open day and night to receive them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You shall not fail. Your children will not fail. You will not lose any of your children. You will not lose any of your children. There will be a source of joy to you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God will bring you divine purpose. People will help you in ministry. People will lift up your hand. Like those who have lifted up the hand of the Lord. So shall it be. In the name of Jesus Christ. You shall be well with you. You shall continue to be well with you. You shall continue to be well with you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jehovah God. Bless them be your holy name.
Hallelujah.
Jesus, mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Bless them be saying this together. And come with your prayers.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Be seated. Be seated. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
This afternoon, it was amazing. When Ayomide. When he was singing, when I woke up this morning, when I was praying for all the ministers that's present, what came to me was Exodus chapter 2, verse 25, and Isaiah. He said, I will look upon you, I will acknowledge you, I will uphold you. I don't know what I'm standing here on behalf of Christ Living Church, not me, not my husband, not Pastor. The Christ Living Church, Pastor Lawan. Friday, Saturday, you are here. Not only here, the choir and praise. We thank you. On behalf of Christ Living Church, we say thank you. The Lord will support you.
Amen.
When you need people, when you need one person, unpaid people, we are there.
Amen.
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 I go to my mommy and daddy. Pastor, you know, Pastor and Mrs. Omobito. I don't know what to say. A word of my mouth is not quantified. It cannot quantify your help, your support, your everything, your choir, your voice.
Amen.
The Lord will be with you.
Amen.
The Lord will raise you up.
Amen.
He will raise your help up. He will raise your children up.
Amen.
He will raise your ministry up.
Amen.
Your gift that is in you, it will come out.
Amen.
We say thank you. We say thank you, mommy and daddy. Daddy, we say thank you. Thank you for, I know you live far. Because I think when you have your granddaughter, we went there, it was a far place. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your support. Thank you for your prayer. Even when you are not here, we know that you are praying for us. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Mama. Thank you, Papa. You know when we went to Malta, I said we get a stage where you don't call people pastor anymore. Where you don't call people even father anymore. You say Papa. I said in the code of my teaching in Malta, Papa, what can I say? You started with us and you finished with us. But we thank you for your support, for your encouragement. We can come to you. You don't say, ah, Pastor King is small in age. Anything, you always show up. You always come in, you always, we thank you for your support Friday, Saturday. Thank you. Samuel, thank you. You did well. The Christ in the church say thank you for your gift. When you went to DC, it was when the pastor left there, I can't believe it. Everything just changed. Thank you for your anointing. Lord, I pray everything that was on you. I love you. I am the butter boys. The Lord will anoint you more and more. Pastor Nika, we thank you. We thank you for your support, prayer, and everything. Even you gave all your wife. You gave me and your wife and your children. They have left the church, but you still allow them to come. Anything we do, they are fully support. We thank you for that and for that love that you have for our church. And they come, they cook, they do everything. thank you, Pastor Jessica. Thank you. I thank who am I thanking now? I thank Ologun Pastor and Mrs. and Pastor and Pastor Ologun. They are my friend. How many years ago? 35 years ago, when we were in the secondary school. 35 years ago, and we were still friends. We were still close. Oh, I will thank you. We thank you for the gift of God that is upon you. Thank you for the love. We don't look old. Even we are old. We don't. We thank God. And thank God for our prophetess. We thank you for the anointing. We thank you for the gift. We thank you for when you pray, the devil shake. When you pray, the devil know that somebody is praying. We thank you for your support. Apart from coming here Friday and today, maybe yesterday you went to somewhere. Even before the anniversary started, you have already prayed. You send prayer, you send everything. We love you. We thank you. Thank you. The Church of God say thank you. My sister, my doctor, my everything. I got my auntie, and my auntie is not. You know, you have auntie that and you have in-law that supersede your auntie. Can you believe that? That's my in-law there. Pastor. I mean. Pastor. Dr. Adeyemi, thank you for your support. My auntie, he will never leave me. Like, God will never leave us, will never forsake us. But what I do, he only come. I only relate to him and to her. Thank you for coming. Thank you for your support. How do I introduce, to thank the man of God? I call it Brother Ibinyeka, Uncle Ibinyeka, Minister Ibinyeka, anything that comes to my hand, to my mouth, I always come. What can I say to you? He came from Nigeria. He always come, every anniversary he will come. You know, last year, Pastor prayed. He said, Lord, let Mr. Ibinyeka come again this year. And indeed, God has answered our prayer. You are here again to celebrate this. We thank you. We thank you for your support. Financially, everything. Your wife is amazing. We thank you. You bring things. You bring so many things. Because of the love you have for God. The Christ in the Church, we say thank you. Thank you for the anointing of God upon you. And we have another mama in our midst. She come to our church at times when she's available. Our mama, Miss Ibi, Auntie Nika, we thank you for coming. We thank you for your support at all times. You always, whenever she comes to the church, she always pray. She always pray. She said, this church will grow. This church will grow. And it's just the love. We thank you. I got my wife, Mrs. Aki. Thank you. I got my brother as well. Thank you, Akiwumi. We thank you. Not like I cannot thank you. I don't want to thank you. You're a member. You are full of everything. But we need to thank everybody that's present here. And we, the Church of God, Christ Living Church, they are thanking you for present, for making your time. Look at time now. After six, you are still here. We thank you for your support. We thank you for the love that you have for God. We just thank you. And before I go, Pastor, we need to thank Mama. And I want, please, I want everybody just to let Mama come out. We have Mama in this church. Mama is, I don't know what to say about Mama. She loves God. She loves God. She wants the church everything. Everything. She wants everything to be perfect in the church. Is I always call in Pastor Akim's mom. Because everything is Pastor Aki. I said, oh, I'm not your daughter, it's your son. It's your son. He loved Pastor Aki so much. He can do anything for Pastor Aki. So I want her to pray for him. He's getting old. I just want to pray for him. I mean, to pray for her, for more strength, for more power. He got children. to God be the glory, all our children, even the woman among them married to pastor, all our children are pastors. So he loved God so much. Her husband was a pastor before he passed away. She loved God so much. I just want us to pray for her. I want us to, Mama, come out. We just want you to, I want people to pray for you, Mama. You are just a pillar in this church. I want people to just to pray for Mama. Just to pray for Mama. Please, rise up and pray for Mama. Pray as you like. Pray as the Spirit of God. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, Lord, Father, we thank you, Father. We worship you, Lord. For my mind, oh, Father, for strength. Oh, Lord, Father, for more than we do, Father. In the name of Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, we give you all the praise and the glory. We exalt your name,
Father, thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
In your draw,
thank you, Lord.
In the course of message, we heard about your excellency, your supremacy,
yes, Lord.
Your wonderfulness.
Yes, Lord.
We give you glory, Lord.
Hallelujah.
We magnify your name,
Lord. Yes, Lord.
We thank you for our mommy that we are praying for. The Bible makes us to understand in the book of Luke, even when Christ was born and was taken to the temple, Simeon was so glad. He said, "For my eyes have seen the glory of the Lord, our Lord, our God." Anna came in as well, the woman that had been waiting for the glory of God. Father, Lord, we thank you for her mommy, for she's seen the goodness of God even in her lifetime. We've had a great testimony. All our children, they are ministers of the Lord. Even the lady among them, married to the minister of God.
Hallelujah.
Our Lord, our God, we thank you for the glory of our hope, our Lord. We magnify and exalt your name. Father, Lord, we thank you for our mommy, for the support she's giving to the ministry, for the encouragement she's giving to the man of God. Father, we bless you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Our Lord, our God, you that have positioned her in this place, going to use her mightily in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Everything she's thinking about is for your goodness. Father, Lord, be gracious unto her in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our Lord, our God, you are the one that created heaven and earth. You have created earth. And in this place you have positioned her. The remaining blessing that you have positioned in her hand for this church, let her deliver it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And in return, let her hand be greater than her beginning in Jesus' name. Father, Lord, we thank you. This year our mommy is here. Next year she shall be here in Jesus' name. Years to come she will be here in Jesus' name. And all the glory will return to you. Adventure mommy is looking for one thing or the other. And she said, "Lord, when will you do this?" As Simeon is saying, "I want to see the glory of God." She will see the glory of God in Jesus. In this land, Lord God Almighty, you are the one that take away the captive of the mighty. Everything that belongs to her that may be hanging upon in the hand of anybody, in the hand of power of principality, we will take it by force for her in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. And our joy will be full to the end.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank
the relationship between her and the pastor misses, we got to bind together more and more in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Satan will not come in between
Amen.
Them. And you may be glorified.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank
in God. Jesus' name we declare.
Amen.
Above all, we thank God, and we thank God for all the members. Sister Lola, you are wonderful.
Amen.
We thank God for all the members of even those people that are not here. We thank God for all the members of Christ Living Church. We thank God, and I need to thank Pastor as well. Pastor Aki, we love you. Your humility is awesome. I don't know what. I thank God for the love that God you have for God. And we pray, we all just pray for you. And that God will continue to elevate you.
Amen.
God will continue to be with you.
Amen.
And you will never fall, you will never falter. My child of God will be upon you. You will not tire.
Amen.
You will not weary.
Amen.
You will not discourage.
Amen.
You will not fall.
Amen.
I will not make you to fall.
Amen.
And your children will not make you to fall.
Amen.
The church of God will not make you to fall.
Amen.
Our future will not make you to fall. Yeah. In the name of Jesus, we say thank you as well. The whole church asks us to say thank you for your prayer, for your testimony. Thank you.
Thank you very much. God bless you.
So we call Pastor Kami to come and take the greetings.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's just share the grace together. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
the love of God, the sanctification of the Holy Spirit,
rest on the man with us now and forevermore.
Amen.
Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus is
Lord.
Jesus
is love.
Jesus
is love.
Now you will talk to somebody and you will sing unto them. Talk to somebody now. You say, person, I don't want you to be picking all over the place. Just choose anybody and talk to them.
Jesus is love.
Verily, verily, verily,
I say unto you, you shall be blessed, you shall be lifted, you shall be well.
Now, come to somebody else.
Verily, 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 I say unto you, you shall be blessed, you shall be lifted, you shall be well with your soul.
Now, say it to yourself now.
Verily, 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 I say unto you, I shall be blessed. I shall be lifted, it shall be well.